सुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमुक्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्याधिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलचलं तत्त्वमस्याधिलक्ष्यं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि ज्ञानमूलं श्रीगुरुमूर्ति पूजामूलं श्रीगुरुपदं मंत्रमूलं श्रीगुरुवाक्यं मुख्यमूलं श्रीगुरुकृपा ओम साईराम। टुडे आई एम एक्सट्रीमली हैप्पी एंड ग्रेटफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू बिकॉज आई गॉट ए चांस टू शेयर माय एक्सपीरियंसेस अबाउट श्री साईनाथ जी एंड फ्रॉम द कोर ऑफ माय हार्ट my special gratitude in the lotus feet of Sri Sainath Ji Maharaj, who is the captain of my lifeboat, who is the sailor of my lifeboat. Actually, I believe whenever I am speaking, I am not doing anything. Sai is within me and he is speaking. Whenever as a teacher, I am teaching the students, I believe that Sai is within me and he is imparting knowledge. Whenever I am counseling any child, when he is in depression, or any parents who have any disturbances and child is not obeying, during that time I believe Sai is there within me. Like me, we all, the children of Sai devotees, in our day-to-day life, in our life we have experiences, we have miracles, we have come across many miracles of Sai Baba. In my life also, hundreds of miracles are there. 2-3 of those miracles I want to share with all of you. In 2010, in Bhubaneswar, I remember in 2010, in the month of August and July, swine flu, it played a havoc. Everyone was panicked about swine flu. And in the month of August, schools were closed. Before the closing of the schools, I stopped the going of school of my son. He was not going to school. He was not playing outside. Exposure was not there, as his immunity was very low during that time. And he is having neurological problem. But from where that virus came, I don't know. He was affected with swine flu in the month of August 2010. High temperature was there. Temperature was 102 and 103 like that. Cough was there. And we both of us parents, we were very much worried about him as he was having convulsion, epileptic child he is. Then we moved to Spurs Hospital in Bhubaneswar. That is a multi-speciality hospital. There we stayed. The doctors tried their level best. His doctor, pediatric doctor, is his pediatric doctor is Dr. P.K. Mahanty. He tried his level best, but temperature was not coming down. Then he advised us to go for the swine flu H1N1 test. Then the test report came. When the test report came that day, doctors called me, and during this period my only duty was I was taking care of my child. His temperature was there. The whole night I was not sleeping. In my bag one Sai Chalisa was there, and that Sai Chalisa was gifted by my younger sister, who is a lecturer in Jupiter Science College. Actually, she is the one who introduced Sai in my life. The first Sai Satcharitra was also given by her only. So that Sai Chalisa was there in my bag. I was keeping my palm on the forehead of my 9-year-old baby, and I was chanting Sai Gayatri as many as times I could, and I was reading the Sai Chalisa. So the next day when the report came, a panel of doctors called me, because during that time, with the good treatment, with all facilities, many persons, they were not surviving. In medical, I have seen many persons, they were not surviving, they were not recovering in swine flu. So doctors called me, and they thought that I will be depressed, I will be disheartened. So they told, your child is swine flu positive, don't be worried too much, and don't be disheartened, but you have to shift to Apollo Hospital. But I was not disheartened. One strength came to me, and one inner voice came from my heart that I am there with you. I am there with your son. My blessings are with there. Nothing will happen. Your child will be all right. So I told the doctors, it's all right. He will be okay. Then I became astonished. We were admitted in Apollo Hospital. Hospital was not appointing. It was denying the admission of my child into that hospital, because during that time, they were not allowing the swine flu patients. With much difficulty, we got a ICU, semi-ICU bed. So in the morning, night, we left the Spurs Hospital, and my child was admitted in Apollo Hospital, Bhubaneswar. But you see all, Sai's miracle. The next day morning, fever was not there. Temperature was normal. Within 2-3 days, my son became well, and we went back to our home. So this is the greatest miracle in my life. And I believe Sai only came, and Sai only saved my child. Another thing, in that very year, my husband went to an astrologer, Dr. Pradeep Chaudhary. He is also a Sai devotee. He told my husband that your son, some remedy is needed. So in Sai temple, in one Friday, you arrange one Arna Bhojan of 20 Brahmins, because his Venus period was going on, and 20 number, it is favorable for Venus. So for that remedy, we organized one puja of Shirdi Sai Baba. Morning time, we all went, all family members. Sai Baba Snanam and everything was over. Kakad Arati and all. Then the person who was arranging this feast, he told that 20 Brahmins, they will come from the nearby, they will come from the nearby Shiva temple. So they arranged everything. But when around 12:30, all came, 19 Brahmins came. One Pandit was absent. He was missing. So we became worried. My husband and my father-in-law counted, 19 are there, what to do? Then I told, the person who is arranging, he is not a Brahmin, but I believe Brahma Janati Iti Brahmanam. So he is also a Brahma, he is also a person, so let him sit and eat. Meanwhile, what happened? One Pandit came with Rudraksha Mala. He was completely fair, Gauravarnam. Then he was tall also, and like Sai Baba, he was having beard on his face. He came alone, he came not with these 19 people. He sat in a corner of that temple, Sai Baba temple. He took his food. He was very much silent, completely calm and quiet. And he took 21 rupees dakshina from my child's hand, and he went away. Then the persons who were arranging that feast, they thought that we call that Brahmin, that Pandit, but he has not come with those 19 people. So we asked, who was that person who came later? They told that we don't know. We thought that you have invited that Pandit. So I believe Sai Baba only came to that temple in the form of in the incarnation of that Brahmin. And from that date onwards, the real treatment of neurology started for my child. We went to Bangalore, and his treatment started. He was not able to walk. Now he is walking, and he is in class 10. Like this, many miracles are there. Sai is there to change the mental setup of people. Sai is there to change with his miracles, with his reading of Sai Satcharitra. As he is saying, no, you come one step forward, I will come towards you. You just give your devotion. You see me in each and every object and each and every animals and human beings, and I will help you. So Sai is helping. Sai is within us. He is guiding us. He is inspiring us in our each and every step of life. Then I was a lecturer actually after my post graduation. Then for my some personal family problem and my child's health issue, I left the job in the year 2006. Then 11 years, I was not in a job. I was at home only. I was taking care of my child. But some sort of depression was there. I was thinking I must get one job. My passion is teaching. I must go outside. I should teach children. I should counsel the children. I am having the potential, but I am not able to utilize it. This type of thinking was there. And I was praying, Sai Baba, please, Baba, help me. So in the year 2017, January month it was, two marketing persons of marketing people were there in Narayana School, Bhubaneswar. In Patia, one branch opened. Narayana School is having 356, more than 356 branches all over the world, I think. So they came. So they saw me and they came for my son's admission. And they told me that, madam, you are high qualified. Why you are not going for any job? Then I asked them politely, any vacancy is there in your premium institution? Then they told me, tomorrow we'll call you. You come and for this reason, you have to meet our general manager. So I thought they came for admission. So they told like this only. So I didn't take it seriously. Then the next day, around 10 o'clock morning, phone call came. I told today I am busy with my household work. I'll come tomorrow. Again tomorrow, it was Tuesday. Again, January. Then what happened? I went to that school. And after my interview, means just one sort of discussion was there. And that general manager was happy with my presentation, my certificates and all. And I was having 6 years experience as a lecturer. So what he saw in me, I don't know. I was not having any experience in marketing. He made me area manager, marketing area manager of that school, of my locality. So I was there successfully. 10 persons, 10 marketing executives were under me. And in marketing also, I did well in that school, Narayana School. Then as my passion is teaching, I wanted to teach only. I told them, sir, marketing is okay, but I want to impart knowledge to children. Without teaching, I cannot stay. Then they told, a good teacher is always a marketer. Then meanwhile, in English, one vacancy was there. I gave, my post-graduation is in social studies, political science. In English, I gave the demo and they were very much pleased with it and I became a teacher. So after 11 years gap, someone is coming to my home and he is calling me to be a teacher and to be to be a part of an institution like a school of national repute. It is what? It is only Sai's blessing, I think. With his blessings only, I am living. With his blessings only, I am doing my work. And as a matter of responsibility, I am doing each and every work. And in each and every human being, I see Sai's face. If someone is scolding me also, I am not irritated. Because I think Sai is there in him. And for some good reason only, he is scolding me. Because Sai Baba has said, no, Sardha and Saburi. Patience is highly needed in anyone's life. If you want to lead your life successfully, you have to be patient. Without patience, nothing will happen. Patience is needed. Bhakti is needed. Devotion is needed. firm faith in God is needed. If you have firm faith in God, then patience will automatically come. And if patience is there, then success will automatically come. Life is full of struggles, but when Sai Baba is there with us, nothing is difficult, nothing is a struggle. Everything will be very easy. No complexity will be there. And with Sai's blessings, everything will be normalized. And for one more miracle, I am waiting. My father, who is a Sai devotee, now his treatment is going on and he is not able to walk. But still, I am having firm faith in Sai. Within a couple of months, he will walk. Then, again, one more miracle will be added in my life. Thank you.